Welcome back to the basement.
Welcome back to the basement yard. How's everyone doing, Frank?
I'm fine.
Okay.
I'm violent. I think is what I said.
I'm so violent
I'm
right
dirty.
Now.
I'm a violent prick, yeah?
Okay, so the reason why we're all giddy and laughing our fucking asses off right now is because...
Well, first of all, we're laughing because of Big Water Joe.
Oh,
well... Well, Big Water Joe. Guys, ladies and gentlemen, he's here. Big Water Joe. Didn't you recently make fun of me for having one of those?
No.
How much was that? Those things aren't cheap. They're like 30 bucks.
This was like 15 bucks.
I need that.
It was literally like the first one I saw on Amazon.
Can I have it?
I like it because it has a nipple.
What? Oh. You suck that bad boy down.
Dude, I drink way more when I drink through a straw.
Really? You can't gulp?
Not really.
Remember the thing that we were taught? By the way, welcome back, Basement Yard.
By the way, I'm at around 4:30 right now.
And
dude,
it's definitely not 4:30.
It's 1:20.
Yeah.
I'm ahead of the game.
Well, you know.
There's a river of piss coming, by the way.
How, like, heavy is your pee feeling?
Right now, I'm good because I haven't broken the seal. This morning, I peed in the shower.
You're going to pee by the end of this episode.
Probably hard.
But, like, we'll pee while the cameras are rolling.
What?
Pee while the cameras are rolling. You got the bathroom right there.
No, I'm not going to piss while the cameras are rolling.
I love when people say, like, you'll drink, like, a gallon of water and they'll be like, oh, you're fucking... your bladder must be so small. It's like, hey, first of all, fuck you. Don't talk about my bladder.
Talk about the size of my bladder.
Second of all, you see how much liquid you're bringing in?
Yeah.
It makes sense that you pee every 10 minutes. Like, yo, if I drank that, I'd pee, swear to God, every 8 minutes.
Well, what's going to happen is I'm going to break the seal, and then it's going to be every 8 minutes. I'm going to be...
And you got fat dick when you got to pee.
Oh, my God. The fattest wiener.
Just a wet wiener.
Not wet.
Like, it's like a squeegee. Like, it's just filled with water.
Yeah.
And you squeeze that bad boy, you're just gonna just leak.
You ever, like, if you have to pee real bad, and then you go to the bathroom.
Yeah.
And then, but the pee comes out, and it's kind of, like, hesitant at first. Like, are you sure? Yeah, it's like,
Yeah, yeah.
And you're that, like, no, we gotta pee right now.
That happened to me this morning when I peed in the car. I started to pee driving very bad.
Big driving piss friend.
Yeah, I hope Geico ain't listening.
Oh. I don't think that's on the insurance.
You know what? That's a good point.
Yeah.
That's a good point. But I guess it would be considered distracted driving.
Or like flood insurance, maybe? Piss all over that thing?
I see what you're doing. And I'm not peeing that much. But like it started. It started and then it was like, we got like the urgent pee out, but like we can hang for a little bit.
I don't know how you cut off a pee. I got to empty the whole thing.
Really? See, like my
dick
is like, if I have to pee urgently, it's like, it'll open the door and like let the right amount of people in to like a club. You know, you'd be like, all right, just go. And then they'll shut the door again. They'll be like, all right, now you guys can wait.
If my bladder was throwing a house party, the cops would be called in 5 minutes because the doors would open and everything would come
Everything's
out.
Just coming
Everyone's
out.
Invited.
Your pee hole just looks like the elevator from The Shining.
Yes.
Minus the blood.
Yes. Well, yes. Well, why did I do that?
Say, why did you hesitate like
definitely
that?
Definitely not pissing blood.
Yeah, I hope not. I saw recently.
Although
that-
this morning I pissed and it was like gold.
Really?
It's because I've been yesterday morning I drank a lot of water. So when you drink a lot of water and your body just starts pissing and pissing and
pee-pee.
Pissing. So then it's used to pissing.
It needs more water.
So I didn't give it
more
water.
I've pissed like amber. Like I've pissed like whiskey amber.
This? Oh.
That's orange.
Yeah.
Like that.
I've never pissed like this.
I gotta be honest. I like when my pee's that color. Like a gold. I don't know if you guys can probably see it. Maybe.
Oh, you like that?
Yeah. Like that's more appealing than a clear pee.
Clear pee is fucking boring.
Boring as shit. I want like a hearty gold.
Yeah. Can you turn your pee a different color if you drink enough like food dye or something?
I remember years ago when you're going to make fun of me for this, I was taking multivitamins from bodybuilding.com and my pee was lime green. Like lime.
That's fucking dope.
Green. And I think it was because there was some pill that I was taking that was like just not... Don't take like these like bodybuilding multivitamins. Not that I was a bodybuilder.
Yeah.
But like there was one that was like very clearly like turning my pee like, and I mean like green, dude.
That's kind of sick.
Kind of green. I also remember there was
like absinthe.
Yeah.
Or like hypnotic. That would be really
hypnotic.
Cool.
Was blue.
I know, but it was like one of those neon
like
colors.
Remember the mixed drink, the Incredible Hulk, Hypnotic and Hennessy.
Oh, that sounds disgusting.
Our New Yorkers know what's up with that. That was my Euro step.
Unsure what that was. But.
And then I took one supplement that I would, like, my bowel movements would be blue.
You would shit blue? Dude, I'm jealous.
It probably wasn't good. If that's what it's doing to your body, if it's that unnatural, don't use it.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes if you have like foods or candy or whatever that's a different color, it'll like kind of morph your butt in front.
Did you see that there was someone that got hospitalized by shoving a USB cable in their penis hole?
I did, actually.
Bro, they wanted to measure how big their dick was by going inside.
Dude.
Fucking genius. Well, I mean, the way they did it was stupid.
Yeah, yeah. You don't... Also, how are you measuring with a USB cable?
How are you getting it in there?
I think you need to start with... You're not starting with the USB slot.
No way. Headphone jack.
Yeah, the headphone part.
That is made to go in a penis.
You can funnel that in there. But, dude, I can't even get the fucking... The band... Like, when the... Like, the tie band...
Ah.
And when it gets stuck in your waistband, you have to, like, funnel it out. Like, dude, imagine funneling in a...
Throw the pants out at that point. I'm wondering because, like, you need to, like, if you push, it'll just crumple up. So, like, you would have to, like, have, like, a stick on it.
You have to have something on the other side.
You know, like a skewer.
Yeah, right.
You know, so, like, tie kind of like a, you know,
oh,
like
to feed
a,
it in.
And feed it in. That's the way to do it.
Right.
But, like, this person was playing, they're living in the year 4000. Because it's like, yo, they could be like, yo, outside, my dick is only, like, 5 inches.
Mm-hmm.
But inside, it went on forever.
Yeah.
You know, and you can just say, like, yo, I haven't been able to stop. Like, I stopped counting measurements at 7 inches.
Yeah. I mean, he's probably going to pay the price.
Pay
the Price, by the way, is a card game.
It's a card game.
That me and Greg made.
Definitely not me, because it wasn't included.
PayThePriceGame.com. Go get yourself a copy of Pay the Price, you pieces of it. S and shit.
Ooh, yeah.
Also, by the time this comes out, because tonight I'm doing a live
Instagram
game show with people. You're gonna win money. So
really?
Yeah, people win money.
Can I win money?
Yeah, join in.
All right.
Yeah.
But yeah, this guy just kept going with this USB cord.
Yeah.
In his PP.
Well, people are into what they're into. You know what I mean? Maybe he got some sort of satisfaction from that. I actually pulled up a nice TikTok that you know, there's someone who is, that's him. He is into what he's into. You know what I mean? Some guys are into whatever, and this is his. I'm just going to play it.
Before you play it, though,
yeah.
I mean, it's from That Weirdo,
mm-hmm.
And he has quite... Are those real tattoos?
I didn't ask him. I'll text him.
Do you have his number?
I don't.
Oh, okay. Instantly just drawing a bunch of just red flags here.
Yeah, so we'll see.
Okay.
Here we go, folks.
My girlfriend just informed me that she has another tasty fart.
Another what?
Is there a tasty fart coming?
Did you say fart?
Soon. Very soon.
Do you want to hear it again?
My girlfriend just informed me that she has another tasty fart.
Tasty fart.
Is there a tasty fart coming?
Yeah.
When?
Soon.
How soon?
Very He's very soon. Impatient.
Look at her face.
I can't tell if she's into this or not.
She's waiting for the fart. The tasty fart.
The tasty fart. So different than just farts.
Well, all right. So that was going to be my first question. How would you categorize a fart as tasty?
I would think that if you're into eating farts, the grosser the better.
Ugh.
The tastier. The more flavor.
Like one of those things where you could smell it and like you taste it?
Yeah, because sometimes you fart and it's just like, boof, and then there smells like nothing. But other times it's like, tumch, and it's like, yo.
Wow.
We need to leave.
I need to, so what's the one, a big fart doesn't smell, is a? Okay. A big fart, little wet, not a big smell.
Yeah, like a disgusting, dude. Disgusting.
And then just a fucking gross ass shit fart.
Yeah. A gross ass shit fart. But yeah, no, this guy.
What would he classify as a tasty fart? Give me the mouth.
Oh, I think he's pooping this guy. He'd love that.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, and I have a feeling that's exactly what her farts kind of smell like.
Oh, my God, that's disgusting.
Yeah, a tasty fart.
Poor woman. She was just trying to pass gas in peace.
Well, I don't think so. You know what? I don't know if this girl is in on it because she was like kind of shy.
She kind of was a little uncomfortable.
He's like, where's the tasty fart? And she's like, Yeah, it's coming.
Yeah, it's like, right. And then she's just like laying there, like, like just trying to just fucking fart.
Yeah.
And God almighty.
That's a lot of pressure to put on yourself.
Literally and figuratively.
Yeah.
I don't know if I would ever be able to be with someone who like liked farts.
Who like wanted to fart in your mouth.
Ugh.
Or have you fart in their mouth.
Oh, I would never put anyone's, I swear to God.
Frankie, hold on. How much money to fart in someone's mouth?
Do I have to live with this person?
No. Any person.
Like off the street.
Off the street.
And they're like, fart in my mouth.
Yeah.
No videos?
No.
Nothing like so like they'll I'll fart in their mouth, they'll never I'll never see them again, they'll never see me again.
Unless you want to keep this money coming in.
Okay. So I'm saying
and don't go high on
alright, honestly. I'd say $2,500 a fart.
That's an expensive tush.
You want my fucking
dude, to fart? You're gonna fart anyway. Your body has to.
I don't care what it has to do.
$500. $500, I'll slam one in you.
Boom. That's like, you know, that's the common saying when people are like, give a rich person $600, they turn it into more. You already have it. Money's trivial to you because you're a fucking sewer rat that gave your soul to the devil.
Jesus Christ.
I need all the help I can get.
Dude. Imagine you all the help you can get. You're stumbling upon a machine of fart money.
But like, will they be with me all day every day?
No.
So then that's the thing is like, if it's gonna be appointment fartation.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to see them and be like, yo, I'm ready. $2,500. All right. I'll say this. $1,500.
That's per fart.
I'll do it or $2,000 a whole day.
How did you get that?
I don't have to let them know when I'm farting.
Okay.
They don't need to know.
Would you sell your fart if someone was like, yo, I'm going to buy your fart, but you got to fart into a jar, close it real quick?
I saw someone did that, and like they kept it for like a year, and it like smelled like shit when they opened it, which is fucking hysterical.
What a fucking idiot that person is.
That is really funny.
It is, but
I would... Waste of time.
Well, no, you just kind of leave
it. All right, so ask me the question again.
How much money? What is the minimum amount to fart into someone's mouth? And let's just say it's a woman. She's like, I'm going to pay you, you know.
Yo, $1,500. I'm sorry. Like, they will never be able to come back from what they see by having my fucking whole. Can I wear pants?
Yeah, you could wear pants.
Oh, so $600. $700. $800. That's it. Okay, that's where I'm drawing the line.
I'm going back to six. Dude, if you can wear like a pair of like mesh shorts, but you can't wear underwear.
I'm just like, it's.
It's so disgusting.
I'm saying like at least per fart. I'll say this. Per fart.
Let's just assume it's one fart.
Per fart, $500, or you can pay me a full day for $2,000.
That's reasonable.
Unlimited farts.
Unlimited farts.
Unlimited farts in your mouth. Some could be tasty.
Some could.
Others I don't know.
Right.
Are they going to be pumping me full of like a special diet in order to like just.
I mean, they'll probably just ask you like if you're lactose. Like for me, I'd be like, yo, you give me some ice cream in here? We'll be all right.
Ugh.
Yeah.
But like you might squirt.
I think that would be like what they're hoping for. But, you know.
Oh my God. I just got fucking, my spit just got thick.
Frank just got dick?
Thick, Joey.
Oh, I think you said your spit just got dick. Oh, sorry. I just played a video, but I do.
Okay.
I want to play this video because this is what was making me and Frankie laugh before the show started. We watched this video. One of the funniest things I've ever seen in my entire life.
Oh, my God.
This guy went to the Museum of Ice Cream, you said it's called?
Yeah, that's what it looks like, Museum of Ice Cream. You ever been?
No, I haven't.
They got a slide.
No stranger to the ice cream, though.
They have a slide that goes three floors.
That's a big slide.
It's a big old slide.
Is it like chocolate slide or
no? No, it's just a slide.
Oh.
I think it was pink.
Good.
And then this room is part of it. Is they have a swimming pool of... sprinkles.
Yeah.
But they're not real sprinkles. They're like little rubber, like mini dildos.
Mm-hmm.
And
it looks like it's just a pool of sprinkles.
It is.
Well.
But it's like the thing like Scrooge McDuck diving into the thing of coins. You ever see DuckTales?
Of course.
You know, and he dives into the thing of coins and he goes in and like swims.
So wait, hold on. Let's just play it and then we'll talk about
okay,
it.
Okay.
Here we go.
Popcorn.
Play it again. God almighty. Play that shit again.
Parkour.
That's a fucking idiot.
Parkour.
down.
Look at his arms. Look at his arms. Look at his arms when he hits the ground. That's the greatest thing I've ever seen.
One more time. One more time. Just listen. Just listen. Okay, just listen.
Okay. Shh, don't laugh. Don't laugh. Okay, don't laugh.
Parkour.
That is every bit of air leaving this guy's fucking body. Oh my god, that's so funny.
He hit that shit so hard,
that
dude.
That is so funny. Dude, could you just imagine? First of all, have you ever hit the ground like that?
Look at this in slow motion. Look at this.
It's flattened out.
He flattened. Look. He's flat. Look at him. Look at the fucking.
Oh my god. And yo, he bounces, dude.
Look at his mouth open. Oh.
Oh my god. Have you ever, when was the last time you like hit something and did like a
People hurting themselves is so good.
It's so funny.
Fuck. That is funny. But yeah.
When was the last time you hit something and made it sound like that?
Not for a while, man. I think they're funny when it happens.
I mean, when I get over it, because like when you lose your air, you're.
But that's what makes me laugh. Like, the fact that I can't breathe and I'm like, and then I start laughing, which requires more air.
More air.
And I don't have it. I'm just fresh out of air.
Bro, I remember when I was a kid, I fucking fell off of a hammock. And I hit the ground, and I was like,
"Ugh!" It's like that video, that woman with the grapes.
Oh, the grapes.
Hell.
Yeah. Oh. Yo, there was, I don't know if I've told this story on here, but when I was a young boy, when I was like a young teenager, at the lake house, we would go tubing all the time. And hey, for anyone out there that like is interested in someone of the same or opposite sex or whatever, don't like put yourself in that situation with them. Because I remember I was on the tube and we hit waves. And I remember at the time being like, I was like into this girl like quite a bit. And I remember hitting waves and she was just like.
She was doing that?
Bro. And I was just like, this is over. Like, this is over.
And that's what did it for you?
That couldn't see her the same after that.
That's a very George Costanza reason for not like being into her.
It's such
she's like
a.
Nah, she makes weird sounds.
Well, I mean.
Sounds is.
Maybe. But like when you're like. I guess like when you're like you see people at their most like pure, I guess, when they're like getting some form of like pain. You know what I mean? So like in that moment as she was skipping across the water, I just heard it's fucking hysterical.
I honestly love it.
You like really like you think it's that funny?
Yeah. I think it is. I think I said this on here before, but multiple times in my life, I've looked up compilations of people like fainting or like hitting a glass.
Scary.
Yeah, I know, but it's like when they start going, oh my God.
I think the fainting is scary because, like, have you ever been around someone that just fainted near you or had it like a.
Yeah.
Like, I had someone have a seizure literally sitting right next to me.
I've never seen a seizure. I've seen people faint. I fainted.
You fainted?
Yeah.
You okay?
Yeah, I was like 12. Or something. I don't know.
You never told me this. Just want to make sure you're all right.
No, people faint.
Yeah, but like, you shouldn't.
Right. I mean, like, dehydration or
I listen, no. I understand why, but you shouldn't.
No, yeah, of course.
Shan't.
You shan't.
Shan't.
This piss is brewing inside.
Yeah, how you peeing right now?
Nothing. It's just, you know.
If you take your pants off, I swear to God, the elastic that's kind of constricting your bladder, it'll release a little bit, so you'll be okay. You'll feel better.
I feel okay still.
Just take your pants off.
No.
Hmm. Can I ask something before we move on?
Yeah.
That I was thinking. When we saw the guy with the juicy farts, he had face tattoos. Something happened with me recently where I met with someone for work and they had something about them. And it made me think, like, are you one of those people that's like, yo, I don't judge. No judgments here. You know, like when you like when you're talking with someone or when
like
you see
physically?
Yeah.
I mean, it really would depend what it is.
So, like, this person had missing teeth. And, like,
how many?
Couple.
The fronts?
Couple.
Were they, like, a hockey player or something?
No. This person was not a hockey player.
Were the rest of them in bad shape?
They could have seen better days. Mm-hmm. You know, you could tell It was just, but my the thing is, like, I instantly, and I'm not saying this was right, but instantly I went to, like, this person's all fucked up.
Listen, teeth, I think, is the only thing that you could be like, dude, what's going on?
Because I feel bad because dental is expensive. Like, it's not, like,
well, you lose a tooth. It's not health insurance.
Dental's dental, though. Like, you need a new tooth. You need a new tooth. Everyone loses a tooth.
Oh, yeah. I'm saying dental insurance is, like, affordable, actually.
Really?
Kind of. Yeah, it's, like, not... It's nowhere near fucking health insurance.
Well, yeah. But, like, that's how I felt. So, like, what do you... is there anything that, like, physically, when you see someone, like, you instantly go, like, I'm a little judgy. A little bit. Again, not saying it's right, but...
Right.
Like, I see no teeth or missing teeth. Like, this person... You know, Puff's the magic dragon.
Right. But, yeah, I think teeth is probably the big one.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's kind of like, what are you doing? Like, you know you got missing stuff.
Yeah.
You know, or you ever meet, like, just actually happened to me recently. I met one of my friend's relatives, and their teeth were just, like, black.
Oof. Like, and there wine, wasn't any, like, wine black or yeah, coffee black?
No, like wine black. Woo-hoo. And I was like, there is no wine afoot. So what's happening here?
Yeah.
So, yeah, that is kind of like, yo, was there a fire? What was going on in there that this is happening?
Cigarettes.
Yeah, probably a lifetime of that.
Cigarettes come with, like, a look for your teeth and a sound.
Yeah.
You know?
Like an older, raspy woman.
Like, yeah, like a woman, like, you know, like... Ugh.
Yeah, I think missing teeth is probably one. Or when a tooth kind of, like, jumps up, like, over the top lip. Kind
of
like...
Where the,
like,
fuck? Who are you hanging out with, a bunch of llamas, Joey? What the fuck? When the fuck have you saw that on a person?
Yeah, you know llamas don't have top teeth.
And you're just like this all the time?
They just have bottom teeth.
That's kind of wild.
Yeah, I fed one and it was like...
And it fucking sucked on your fingers?
No, I mean, I gave it an apple, but I got a little touch.
You got a little nubs.
Yeah, I got a little nubs. But then the guy was like, yeah, they got no top teeth.
Hmm.
And I was like, cool. I was like, how do you know that, Buster?
Like
that.
Yeah, some people like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, how do you know that?
So there's nothing that you can think of where you, like, get a little judgy?
I mean,
Joey's trying to be nice here, guys.
No, I'm being honest. I mean, I think teeth is the big one because everything else, it's like, how can you really, like, have, or if you have just, like, stupid tattoos.
Oh, if you, like, and I'll take it a step further. Like,
and that's a hard category.
A lot. I know tattoos are tough because, like, body art.
Like,
I get it.
If you get, like, cliche tattoos, that's one thing. Fucking
Roman numerals on your forearm.
Right.
And how many? And your other tattoos? You have none. That's it.
Right. So,
like, the sailor.
Yeah. Who?
Like the sailor that gets the fucking, the pinup girl.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
So dumb. But, like, there's certain tattoos that I'm just like, what are we, like, how can this even be slightly significant? You know what I mean?
It's not. That's the.
Or, like, have any meaning. It's just like, I just like SpongeBob.
Yeah. Like, yeah. I mean, listen, there are a lot of things I really like. I don't know if I want to get them tattooed on me.
But even that, like.
But, like, face tattoos. I'm not saying I'm judging the person in a bad way, but, like, I'm like. This person just has, like, they don't give a fuck.
Yeah, but I don't make a. I mean, it really depends what it is.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if I saw someone with, like, a Mike Tyson face tattoo, I'd be like, okay, this person's fucking insane.
Tribal tattoos
on your face, dude. Like, kind of wild,
bro. Crazy, absolutely.
So
crazy.
I'm like, you know, that's a little much. But, like, I don't know. There's face tattoos that some people have that I don't really think are crazy. Like, when people get this tattooed. Or, I actually like this spot on the back of your ear.
Uh-oh,
like,
here we go. Here we go. What are you going to
get? I'll be in here next month.
Yeah.
Just tattoos all over my shit. But yeah. Are you fucking crying right now?
I yawned.
Oh, I was
like, dude. I'm a little tired. Daughter didn't sleep well last night, and I didn't either.
Mm.
She's teething, which sucks.
She's biting you?
I mean, she's always bitey.
She's
a bitey baby.
Mm.
But her top two teeth are coming in, so she is just fucking miserable.
What do you call her again? Big lady? Big?
I call her a bunch of stuff. So it's Scoob, Scooby-Doo.
You called her, like, big baby.
Little gobble one.
Little what?
Gobble one.
Gobba. Little gobble
one. She's a little gobble ghoul.
Oh.
Yeah. And then big time.
Big time.
Big timer. Big time girl.
Big time girl, I've heard you say.
Yeah. She's my big timer.
Yeah.
That's the thing. It's like, she's a big time. She's also sometimes a happy napper.
She's a big... Yeah, she's a big timer like Manny Fresh.
Big timer like Manny Fresh. Damn. Absolutely, yeah.
Fresh.
Damn, you remember that golden age of fucking music we got?
Boom, boom, clap?
That was called, and then what?
And then what?
Young Jeezy, Joey.
Oh my God.
Come on.
No, that was a... What was the big timer song that was like really popular?
House real big, bar real big, everything real big, rims real big,
what?
Pockets real big,
what?
Rim real big, let me tell you how I live, got that China.
Oh, Still Fly. How does that go?
This
is definitely going to play an advertisement, of course.
Still Fly is, I'm still fly. You remember that?
No.
I mean,
I'm getting confused with like, there's an old Drake song off one of his like early mixtapes.
That was a long end. But here's
what's
remember.
What's up? When, fresh is our turn.
Oh, baby.
We can't do this because we're gonna.
That
song is fire.
That song is fucking big titties.
That's just. Big timers, big titties. You know what I'm saying?
House real big. Call real big, everything real big. Remember at the end of music videos when they'd play a teaser for the next music video?
I love that. Oh, this is just a straight up Manny Fresh song.
Damn.
Let me show you how I live.
Got that 24 ladies, gentlemen, gangsters, pimps. Honeys, daddies, stunners, shiners, rich, bitch, I'm a real big timer.
Oh my God, that's the one.
Damn,
that's
my daughter.
2005, dog.
That's my daughter, big timer. Big timer girl.
She's a big timer.
She's a big timer baby.
Had to play it. Had to get demonetized for the big time girl.
Hey, you don't care because you don't have to worry about payments and anything. I do.
I don't because I'm smart and I would take $500 for a mouth fart.
Oh, well, that's right. I would take $1,500, but that's just because I know my value.
That's how you...
I know I'm really gross, so if someone wants me to fart on them, they know it's going to be really nice.
Well, we got a couple ads for today, so I'm going to get to the first two right now.
Okay, all right.
The first one being BetterHelp.
Oh, it's BetterHelp.
You can start communicating in just under 48 hours with a licensed therapist, okay, in any of the states or, you know, wherever you may be. Like I said, start communicating just under 48 hours. You can switch from therapist to therapist very easily as well. They make that a seamless transition. But yeah, they have clients all over the world. You get timely and thoughtful responses, plus you can schedule weekly video or phone sessions so you won't have to sit in an uncomfortable waiting room or, you know, anything like that. You can do it from the comfort of your own home as well. And you can visit betterhelp.com/yard. That's better, H-E-L-P, and join the over 1 million people who have taken charge of their mental health with the help of an experienced professional. This podcast is sponsored by BetterHelp, and Basement Yard listeners get 10% off of their first month at betterhelp.com/yard. Again, that is 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/yard, folks. Okay? And speaking of, you know, keeping your mental health, you also want to keep your physical health as well. And we have Native here. Native cares about the products you put on your body. They're stopping. They're about stopping the stink the right way. Okay. So they have products like deodorant and they have a sunscreen that are scented or they're scented very beautifully, honestly, I will say. And they are aluminum-free deodorant, but it's great. So they have a body wash. They have a toothpaste. They have like a sunscreen that I've used and it's great. So if you care about that stuff, which you should, because you don't want to put harmful things into your body, then you can start with Native. It's on a mission to overhaul your entire hygiene routine by putting the care in self-care with products carefully made to work against the odor that are made from simple ingredients and smell great. They have coconut and vanilla. Anything that's coconut and vanilla like scented that they have is incredible. So definitely, if you're going to buy that one. Stay fresh, stay clean. So fresh and so clean with Native by going to nativedeo.com/basement20. Use the promo code basement20 at checkout and get 20% off your first order. That is nativedeo.com/basement20 or use the promo code basement20 at checkout for 20% off of your first ODA. Oh, you see that? See what I just did? Your first ODA, like odor.
Ah, that's why you got it.
Pain, whatever.
Speaking of odor.
What are you doing over there?
Working up something fucking stinky.
What?
I'm just wagging my ass. I don't know why I said that. I'm not going to, like, shit my pants or anything. Don't worry.
Oh, you can't have to be shitting. You pissed your pants today.
Well, I didn't pee my pants.
Frankie's goes, I pissed my pants today.
I didn't piss my pants. I peed on my pants. There's a difference. There's a big difference.
How's there a difference? There's piss.
Do you want to finish the ads and then we'll get to this?
No, we're doing two now. We're doing two later.
Okay. I didn't pee my pants.
You pissed.
I pissed on my pants. Peeing my pants means that everything's still inside and I can't get away, you know, get it open quick enough, and I pee while fully enclosed. I pissed on my pants. As I was finished peeing, I went to pull back in, didn't wag long enough, and pee got on my pants. So what did I do? I covered it in hand sanitizer. Speaking of piss, you're gonna fucking pee your... Look at you. You're at 5 p.m. You just drank an hour.
I need to chill.
You do need to chill.
Because
then you know what's going to happen. Is you're going to piss all that out, and then for the rest of the day, you're not going to drink any water.
Yeah.
Fucking big time.
Big time piss problem.
Rich bitch, you're a real big timer.
It's starting to form.
Yeah?
Into pee, yeah. But anyway, so you piss yourself.
I didn't pee myself. I pissed on myself.
On the FDR.
This whole... Well, we don't need to worry about... Well, let's not get into the minutia of where it happened.
On the FDR. Which, I'll say, a lot of traffic. A
lot of traffic on the FDR.
Someone has seen you piss in a jar.
It's UN week, so I don't pee in a jar. Excuse you.
It's UN week?
It is UN week. I have a bottle that I
pee in.
What
does that mean? It's a whole week?
Yeah.
So all the princes...
All the fucking people from the United Nations are here in New York. They pick New York of all places.
Yeah.
Like, what's special about New York?
It's like, hey, what city is super congested that we can make more congested?
Oh, my God. And, like, what do they do?
At the United Nations?
What do they... Honestly, what do they do?
They unite nations.
How?
Chit-chat. I think it's like... I think it's... I think the United Nations is just kind of like therapy for countries.
Oh, but, so they're just like in there, just like a mediation class with Miss Reese in fucking 11th grade?
Yeah, I think they come in there and they're just kind of like, yo, like, Israel kind of like hurt my feelings. And then they kind of like, that's so, a very simplified way of putting
it. I know.
But they got to keep the peace. They got to be like, yo, like, I want to meet you. I want to have a beer.
Bro,
you know, talk about something.
They don't go out and have beers. You think afterward they're like, yo, I'll meet you at fucking McClune's or whatever.
Nah, I think that maybe they go back to their hotel and they have like
they have like buildings for the countries. Like, I remember like there's like the... Like,
mad flags.
Bro, a lot of flags. Those are like one building that's like the Lithuanian embassy. And it's like, that's for them.
I've been to the Canadian one.
What?
Yeah.
When and why?
I was interviewed by their FBI.
Stop.
I told you this.
I don't remember it.
I've told the story on the podcast before, but basically
give us an abridged.
Years ago, mm-hmm. There was a girl...
Oh, yeah, catfish.
Catfishing, using my pictures to extort other people.
That's cool.
And they just needed my statement, but I was under the impression that I was going to be like fucking extradited or
something. Yeah, yeah. No one did that with my picture.
Yeah.
No one has ever done that with my picture.
But it was kind of cool because when you get into the building, they're like, this is Canadian ground. And I was like, do I have to, like...
Wait, so a building in Manhattan is Canadian grounds?
That, like, once you get to a certain point, so, like, if you walk through the lobby, it's not, like, Canada. But I think this could be fucking wrong. This is how I remember it.
And this
it could
doesn't
be,
sound right.
It could be false. But I went there, and then I had to... put all my shit in like a... Basically, like, you're going to the airport.
Mm-hmm.
But there was like this door. Like, there was these double doors that it looked like it was like airtight. Like, I could have suffocated in there or something. And then once I got on the other side, it's like technically we're in Canada now. So that they can like interview me.
So you just go in a room and I can be like, yo, this room is fucking...
Yeah.
Turkey. Yes. And you're in Turkey?
Yeah.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah,
get around laws like that.
I was like, oh, I've been to Canada.
Well, you have also been to Canada.
I know.
But, yeah, I was on when I didn't piss on myself, because I'm not over that. Well, when I pissed on myself, not peed myself.
Yeah.
I was sitting there, and I was like, yo, what? Like, what the fuck do these, like, people do? And, like, who are the people? You know what I mean? And, like, why do they need, like, to have, like, the whole city shut down for them?
I don't know, because I don't get that either, because, like, usually, like, all these diplomats, they have to, like, have a police escort, and it's like, oh, the United Nations is in town, so they're blocking off streets so these people can get to the meeting. It's like, bro, we don't know you. We don't know you guys.
Yeah, I don't know. If you are, like, that dialed in, that, like, you know, like, oh, my God, that, oh, my, you see who that is? That's the fucking ambassador from, you know, Russia.
Yeah.
Like, you deserve.
Guys. Take it easy. I get it. Like, we got to be safe, snipers and stuff. But, yo, one car.
I don't think there are snipers like that, like, readily available.
Yeah, I don't either. Which is also interesting because, like, you see those movies where, like, you know, political figures are getting like shot all the time.
Or that ain't gonna happen.
It's like, bro, where are these random snipers? Like, yeah. That are like shooting people from like a garage 10 blocks away. Like, what the fuck?
I mean, fucking, what was his name? James Earl Jones? No, that's Darth Vader. The guy,
what's his name?
That killed Kennedy. Roy.
Oswald.
Roy Oswald.
Is it Roy? No, that's a.
That's a pitcher.
That's a pitcher.
It's a former pitcher for the
Lee Houston. Harvey Oswald.
Lee Harvey Oswald. Roy Oswald.
Roy Oswald. I looked
very good pitcher, by the way. I remember him.
Lee
very
Harvey.
Good with the Astros. Quite the pitcher.
I'm pretty sure it was Lee Harvey Oswald.
Oswald. There we go.
Yeah, this is him.
Yeah, and then you remember he got killed on TV by Jack Ruby. There's a video of it.
I've seen it.
Of Jack Ruby just going like, pop.
Yeah.
A fucking Wild West 1963, man. Let me tell you.
Crazy. No rules.
They can do whatever they want.
Pretty much.
But, so then, because I never knew what the UN, like, who they were, what they did.
I've been to the UN. Did you come with me?
First of all, you don't invite me places with you. Second of all,
I was fucking super young and it was a fucking field trip. That's why I'm asking.
Still didn't get invited. An invite would have been nice.
I can't invite you, bro.
Well,
if you didn't get your permission slip signed.
No, I haven't been to the UN, but I know people that have worked at it.
I've been to the UN. I don't know when I went. Maybe it was in sixth grade then, because it was very like early on.
This is Lamb's Hotshot days.
Yes.
Gotcha. It was Lamb's Hotshot.
That's my old screen name. So we went to the UN and it's actually cool. Because, and this is probably not super cool because this technology has clearly been around for so long, but it was like mind-blowing to me that they let us go into one of like the meeting halls or whatever the fuck.
They're really dark. Aren't they like really dimly lit?
In the back they are.
Yeah?
You know what I'm talking about? Danger. That's where danger lurks. In the shadows. And they have shadows in there.
They have a lot of shadows in
right
the UN.
In the room.
The shadowy. I assume they're a shadowy organization.
Yeah. There's stuff going on in certain rooms in there that you don't really know what's going on. But when people are talking, you can put on this earpiece and change it to any language so that the Russian people, when people are speaking English, they're getting it in Russian in their ear.
That's kind of cool. Why haven't we made that yet?
It was made. I was in like fifth grade.
Okay, but like why can't I use it? Like if I'm walking on the street and I just hear like two people just like talking shit about me in Arabic, I can just be like, oh.
Well, no.
Why do we have silent discos and we don't have that fucking technology yet?
Silent disco is so fucking dumb. No, I think it's, actually it's pretty smart, but I think it's somewhat like an interpreter is like talking.
Oh, okay. So they're just like dialed
I don't think
in.
It's like, fuck dad. Don't. I just called you dad.
Well, I'll be your daddy.
I argue with him a lot. So
then I'm definitely your
dad.
I'm definitely your dad.
No, but, yeah. So it was fucking crazy that day, but I've been to the United Nations. So I didn't see anything, but I did think like, yo, I'm gonna open up a door where I'm not supposed to.
And you'll get fucking clapped.
I had to. They were like really. I think that was the first time in my life. This is how young I was that I walked through a metal detector and that someone patted me down and gave me the wand.
Ooh.
Yeah. So I was like, damn, this place is like fucking.
Well, what the fuck were you gonna do?
I don't know.
Who are you?
Crazy people. They attach like bombs to children or something.
I guess. Yeah, that's kind of fucked up.
But yeah, I don't know, bro.
No. Yeah. I up until literally today, I was like, do they just go there and they're just like
chilling?
How's Nepal? Good? Cool. Next, yeah. Myanmar. You guys good? Like, and then is it like fucking like new business? They'll be like, all right, like I vote to talk about new fucking business. Let's bring up like getting everyone.
They probably control the weather. They're probably like, yo, more rain.
Oh, that's exactly what it does.
They're like, yo, more rain in the northern hemisphere.
I love how they used to be like, yo, like it's going to storm only if you talk about what Israel's doing right here. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. And it's like, all right, like fucking chill out.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. It would be interesting to kind of see. I wonder if they like have like pizza parties, you know, because if they're here for the whole week, it's like, all right, we're here for the whole week. Friday, casual pizza party.
Pizza never tasted as good as when it was like a party in like first grade. And you just had like a Dixie cup of Coca-Cola and a pretzel rod that you pretend to smoke like a cigar.
Duh.
And then you pretend to be drunk off soda.
Well, I didn't.
And you get a quarter slice of a slice of pizza.
Yo, low key, I think pizza tastes better when it's cut into sixteenths.
Who the fuck are you?
You don't like that?
No, I want a fat dude. If I could, I'd eat a whole pie right now. I'm hungry.
I feel like there's a better chance of me eating a pie when it's cut into sixteenths.
Bro, do you know that when I was in college, we would get pies that were cut into squares?
That's the dumbest fucking thing I've ever
had. I know, but like there's like Sicilian pies, but like, yo, it was like a pie that I swear to God was as big as this table, and they would cut it. It would made into a square or rectangle.
One square?
And they would fucking, like a fucking grid. And then like someone would be stuck with like a middle piece with no crust on it.
I like a middle piece.
I do too, but you need a little crust.
I mean.
And like when it's like hot, so like all the fucking shit just goes to the middle, so that middle piece is just like oil and just mush.
And mushy mush. That is a disgusting sound.
Really?
That sounds like my dog drinking water.
I can do that. Close your eyes.
Good boy. Ew, disgusting. Yeah, no, I haven't been to a pizza party in years either.
I'd love to.
Dude, remember when you as a kid used to always throw up at those things?
I only...
David, bro. David was a
David
big...
fucking loved to throw up.
He loved to throw
up. I remember he burped through up something in third grade on his desk. It was brown.
Dude, I was literally just going to bring this up.
I did first.
In third... Yeah, Miss Pogerman's class.
Yeah, he was sitting in the back.
Kid threw up.
It was brown.
It literally looked like...
McDonald's barbecue sauce.
Yep.
Bro.
I was thinking more like a beefaroni type of thing.
Dude.
Disgusting.
It was brown. Like solid brown.
I brought him to the nurse that day. And the nurse was... I was like, yeah, this kid threw up. Like, whatever.
Oh, I used to fake
And David was just kind of nurse. Like, oh my God. Like, you know...
Bro, whatever. I used to go to the nurse all the time.
I said, yeah, dude.
I used to fucking love it.
Dude, nothing better than when you're faking sick... And your mom's like, okay, I'm going to come get you.
Oh, that never happened.
I have done it.
It never happened with me.
What?
Bro, my mom worked opposite. If I was legitimately sick, I had to go to school because she wouldn't believe me. And when I would fake sick, she'd be like, just fucking stay home.
Once I found out what a mental health day was, I didn't even know what that meant.
What is that?
A mental health day?
Is that something you can take?
In my family, we would do that.
What?
Yeah. But, like, you would get, like, one a year.
Bro, that's awesome. My mom would be like, yo, I went to school with a fucking sinus infection. And my mom was like, figure it out.
Yeah.
Because she just didn't care.
Yeah.
That's not true. She cared.
One time I had a fever, but I didn't tell my mom because I was like, yo, I got gym first period.
Well, yeah. After.
And I just wanted to play.
After gym, you tell her.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
There were days where I'd be like, yo, I know I have a lot of homework to do. I didn't do any of it. I'm sick.
Yeah.
I'm just not fucking going, dog.
Yeah. I there's nothing better than pulling the wool over your mother. You know what I mean?
What the fuck is that?
Pulling the wool over their eyes. Isn't that an expression?
I've never heard it.
Someone pulled the wool over your eyes?
What does that mean?
Pull the wool over your eyes. There you go. Yeah, it's like you've bamboozled someone, deceived someone by telling them untruths. That's a weird way of saying
untruths?
Lying. Yeah, untruths. Just say lie.
You also said bamboozled, so we're not really doing well with the verbiage today.
Whatever.
No, I never had a mental health day. My mom was so dialed in with all the teachers that like she would know because the teachers would like fucking be like, oh yeah, let's call your mom right now.
One time I didn't feel well and I had my head down on my desk. This is in sixth grade, and my teacher comes over to me and she's like, you can't pray in class. It's a public school. She was a Chinese Spanish teacher, by the way. Failed that. Duh. By the way, didn't really speak English at all. I'm dead serious.
She didn't speak English.
This is a sixth grade Spanish class.
She spoke Chinese and Spanish.
Barely spoke English. So it was very hard to
pass. Kind of fire.
But anyway. So I'm having my head down because I don't feel good. And she comes over and she goes, you can't pray in class. And I was like, at that point I was so fed up and I also fucking hated her that I just lifted my head and I was like, what the fuck are you talking about?
You didn't say fuck.
I 100% said fuck.
Really?
I would give her the fuck all the time, honestly.
Crispy Joe.
Yeah, not good. I was a bad person in her class because I fucking hated her.
Yeah.
But I was just like, what the fuck are you talking about? And she's like, you can't pray. So... My friends come over to my desk and they join hands and start like doing the Our Father.
Of course, yeah.
In like a very culty, like, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Like doing this whole thing.
Was this high school or middle school?
This is middle school. It's sixth grade.
Of course, yeah.
Seventh grade.
Hot shot.
And then I'm about to go home. So I call my mom. My mom's like, all right, I'll come get you when I can. And then I was like, yeah, my mom's going to pick me up. So I just had my head down on the desk And then I'm about to leave, and she hands me a Bible.
Your mom?
No. The teacher.
Your mom likes God.
Her name was Miss She.
That sucks.
Yeah. Ahead of the pronoun game. It was actually S-H-I-H. But she...
what I'd call her.
She hands me a Bible, and I'm like, what? And she's like... Because she couldn't really, like, speak English well. So she didn't really know how to tell me what it... Also, I opened the Bible. It's all in Spanish.
Oh, well, did you throw it out?
It was, like, 2 months into school. I was like, I haven't learned anything yet. What am I going to do with this?
Yeah.
I don't know what I did with that, but I was just kind of like, what? I think I might have left it there.
That's tough.
But, yeah.
So, I remember my dad told me, like, if you're ever sleeping in class, like, and they wake you up, just raise your head and go, amen. And I never did that.
Amen.
Because that would be fucking genius.
My freshman year of high school, our Italian teacher, Mr. Licata, if you fell asleep in his class, he always had like a stick in his hand, right?
Bro, what?
And he would shove it up your ass. He always had a stick in his hand.
I was gonna say, what my teacher?
If you fall asleep in his class, he would just be talking. Like, he wouldn't go quiet. Like, he'd keep talking and then let everyone kind of know, like, I'm about to fuck with this guy.
Yeah.
And then walk over to your desk and then slam it on the desk and just like yell, and like everyone would yell.
That's fucking
so
great.
So people would be like.
That's awesome. I knew we had a teacher that would just like grab a textbook and just drop it next to you.
Yeah.
Did you ever do this where someone was like this asleep and you fucking move their hand?
I've never done that.
I've never done it either, but I want to do it so bad.
I used to fall asleep in class all the time.
There was one class, dude, in college. We had a professor. I fucking hate history. I hate history so much. And I had to take for like core curriculum. I had to take a fucking history class. And he was like, oh, yeah. Ben Karp was his name. Awful name for a professor. You're going to get bullied. And he was like, yo, I don't care what you do in class. You can show up and fall asleep. I do not care. Just show up. So I was like, great. I remember that. Like, I had like early classes that day. So I would go and I would fall asleep. And he woke me up one day. And I was like, why would you do that? And he was like, and I was like, you're a clown. And I got fucking barked at,
you
dude.
Called him a clown?
I called the college professor a clown. I remember I said, you're a clown, BK. He was like, hey, don't call
Damn,
me.
You sunned him.
Sunned the shit
That's
out
fat.
Of me.
Dude, if I'm Ben Karp, I'm slapping you.
Slapping the shit out of me.
I'll fuck my job.
I mean, don't fucking wake. If you say I can come and sleep, don't wake me up when I'm sleeping.
Why would you do that? And then what'd you say?
I was like, you're a clown, BK.
Yo, that is crazy.
Hey, man. That's if you're allowing me to sleep, let me sleep, and that's what you're going to get if you
wake
me
up. Yo, that's
worse
than anything. Not the worst, but like the only thing that I can compare to that, I had a teacher my freshman year of high school who did, like, half the year was bio, half the year was chem. Failed all of them. passed just by a little bit. Yeah. He did me a favor by not sending me to summer school, honestly, but he fucking hated me for whatever reason. The next year, my sophomore year, I get him again for a class, and I walk in, I'm like, oh, God. So, like, it's a week into school.
What was his name? Put it out there.
Mr. Hamilton.
Fuck you.
No, he's my guy now.
Oh, now he's cool.
Well, he's not really my guy.
Oh, fuck you again.
But whatever. We became friends after that. Once I didn't have his class, we were like, all right, dude, like, I don't know why you hated me. Like, whatever. Like, there was literally one time I had a project, and there was a minus 10 on it. And I was just like, yo, why did I get a minus 10, like, on this? And he was just like, I don't.
Fuck you. That's why.
Basically.
That's kind of frat.
It was dope. So good for him. But there was one time that we get into class and he has like a worksheet out. It was like the first week of school. So I'm like, yo, I'm going to start this off on a nice foot here. I don't want to fucking bring whatever last year into this year because he used to hate me last year. So I was doing the worksheet and then all of a sudden he like asks a question to the class. But I'm doing the worksheet that he gave us, right? So he does the classic, like, some kid's not paying attention. So, Joey, what's the answer?
Why don't you tell us the answer?
And I go, and I said, I'm sorry. I was doing the worksheet. I wasn't really paying attention. And he's like, get out of my class. And I was like,
hit you hard with it.
I was like,
it.
For real? And he's like, yeah, get out of my class. I was like, I was doing the worksheet. I wasn't, like, you know, not doing something that involved in class. Like, I was doing the worksheet.
Worksheet Joe.
And then he's like, get out of my class. And I was like, Jesus. So I was like, okay. So I grab my shit and I'm walking out and he fucking slams the door, bro. Hard.
I wish.
And now, so now I'm in the hallway and I was like, what the fuck? So then I opened the door and I was like, relax. Close the door and left. Told him to relax.
Bro.
It was foul. It was a long year. Passed though. No
good,
summer school.
Good for you. Fuck you, Hamilton. That's fucking...
We became cool because I remember my senior year, I wanted him to sign my yearbook. And I came to his class, and then I was like, yo, you gotta sign my yearbook, bro. And he's like, I'm in the middle of the class, I can't do it right now. I was like, okay. I just put it on his desk and made him sign.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm getting the fuck out of here. He was a cool guy, though.
Yeah, that, I mean, it doesn't sound that cool. It sounds fucking miserable.
Yeah, I don't know. I think that he just
kind of... I miss the days when teachers can just fucking unload on you.
Yeah, like, hate some people. Bro, you know what I'm saying?
Like, listen, I get it. Like, there were fucking teachers like, hit people that fucked up. I get it.
Yeah, like, all my parents' teachers hit them.
Yeah, mine too. My mom like came back and she was like, "Yeah, like the ruler was the thing, you know, that was the big yeah. thing." But like, yo, you weren't humbled as a 5-year-old unless your teacher just fucking let you have it, dude.
Yeah.
And I remember I had multiple teachers that would just fucking scream at me.
I would have a teacher. Sometimes teachers would just be like straight up, just be like, "Are you fucking dumb?"
Yeah.
Not like fucking, but they'd be like, "Are you dumb?
Are you kidding me?
Like, are you fucking
like they are
dumb?
So dumbfounded that they're dealing with this dumb little bitch.
Yeah.
That they have to like fucking like just give it to them straight.
Pretty sure a teacher has called me an asshole before.
Oh,
You know what I did? You know what's so crazy how different the world is, right? Teacher calls me an asshole in school.
And you get in trouble.
To me, I'm like, this is a secret I'm going to bury. Because if I told my mom or dad that a teacher called me an asshole,
bro,
they would fucking kill me.
Bro, I love the relationship that Miles and Becca have. But every day, because he started first grade. He started 2 weeks ago. I would say at least 4 times he's come from, like, we picked him up and he goes, I got in trouble. I'm sitting there hysterical because I would never let my family know I got
in trouble. Don't tell them you got in trouble.
I remember I got in trouble for starting a food fight in sixth grade or something along those lines. That, bro, I went home and I unplugged the house phones.
Dude.
I would take the battery pack out of the house phones because I knew that the deans were going to call. So guess what? I got ahead of it.
Yeah.
Yo, if I showed
be
up.
Be smart.
If I show kids today, all these kids that are watching and listening, first of all.
Tell your parents?
To not let you listen or watch.
Yeah, Jesus.
Second of all, don't fucking tell them you got in trouble. Bro, what's wrong with you?
Yeah.
And it's also because, like, now they get in trouble for, like, you know, Miles, like, got in trouble for drawing on the desk. He probably was just, like, coloring on the desk. If I was drawing on a desk. Dicks.
Yeah.
Balls.
I'll probably get like...
Bitch.
Bitch.
You know?
Bitch.
Like, there was no... Like, that's something to get in trouble for.
I'm going to tell a good story right after the last two ads here.
Let's do it. All right, can I try?
No. Okay, yeah, go ahead.
Okay. All right. Well, listen. Something that you will get in trouble for is not being hydrated.
Boom.
All right? And you definitely want to be hydrated because... You need some Liquid IV, baby. Liquid IV is not only going to taste delicious, but it's going to hydrate you, all right? Listen, how do I start my day? I have tea in the morning. What do I have after that? I have that beautiful lemon ginger hydration packet from Liquid IV, and then boom, great way to start the day. Hey, I'm going to have a couple drinks. Have one before, have one after. No headache, no dehydration. It's the best way to go. Okay, well, how do you use Liquid IV? Well, like I said, you get this beautiful little packet that they have at some retailers, and you open it up, and you pour it into your drink. You could pour it into a smoothie. Realistically, you could put it in any liquid that you would like, mix it in, drink it in, and guess what? The bonus is that it actually really tastes good. Not like the other packets that are out there to try to hydrate you that taste kind of chalky. Liquid IV is going to taste great. And that's what I love most about Liquid IV. My favorite flavor, like I said, is the absolute gem of that lemon ginger one. But they got new flavors. They got strawberry. They got watermelon. They got passion fruit. Pina colada. Who likes pina coladas? I do.
Same.
And getting caught in the rain. Please make sure. And I'm actually getting a little stressed out because I've never done this before. So, Joey, you can take over.
Yeah, but so... You just went so...
Sorry. It's my first time. I need to practice.
Oh, yeah. But Liquid IV, everyone knows. Open the packet. You put it. It actually hydrates you more than water does, or quicker than water does, rather. But yeah, you can grab your favorite Liquid IV flavors nationwide at Walmart, or you can get 25% off when you go to liquidiv.com. Use the code BASEMENT at checkout. That is 25% off of anything you order off of liquidiv.com. Just use the promo code BASEMENT. At checkout. Frankie, great job.
Thank you, man. Thank you. Also,
that's enough.
That's
all right. So, and then lastly, here we have HelloFresh. HelloFresh delivers prepackaged ingredients to your house as well as a recipe on how to make it Everything is pre-portioned, so there's nothing goes to waste. You can go on their site and you get some good ideas for, you know, what kind of meals you want to make. That's like the best part about it, is that like a lot of the times I just don't know what to make. Like the only things I could think of making are like chicken and rice and, you know, whatever. But they have some really good meals that are delicious, and all of their food is legit. It's not like, you know, crappy grade food. It's all like great. And it's cheaper. It's 30% cheaper than shopping at a grocery stores. And it's probably a billion times cheaper than eating at a restaurant. They also, the fall harvest is officially on as well with HelloFresh. You can count on seasonal recipes like pumpkin cinnamon rolls. Oh my God. And Friendsgiving ready sides. Okay. So there you go. Go to HelloFresh.com/basement14 and use the code basement14 for up to 14 free meals, including free shipping. That is 14 free meals when you go to basement. When you go to HelloFresh.com/basement14. All right. There you go, folks. Enjoy that.
That was a lot of pressure. I hope I made our friends over at Liquid IV happy.
I'm sure you did.
I actually really do enjoy Liquid IV and their products.
Oh, like, that's fucking great.
We already finished the ads. They're actually good.
No, they're great.
Oh my God. Like, you gave me the keys to the kingdom and I didn't know what to do.
You stole the keys.
I know. Well, I didn't steal them. All right. You gave them to me and you like, here, go fail so I can pick up the pieces.
Okay.
That's why you're smart.
But yeah, the story I was going to tell is that, and I may have told the story before. I don't even know if you would remember the story, but I got in trouble from this guy. I had a video class in eighth grade. In eighth grade, I had a video class that we had to make like videos or whatever. And it was like the first day of class. And this guy, which I won't say his name.
Say it.
Hayworth. He, someone.
You shouldn't have said it. That name sucks.
Yeah. So we were lined up to get into class. Somebody, was not me. Know for a fact it was not me. I don't know who it was. But someone, like, he was like saying like, yeah, we're going to line up and we're getting to class. We're going to do assigned seating. And someone called him Gayworth.
Classic.
Children being kids.
Classic.
Children being kids.
Yeah.
So they called him Mr. Gayworth. And then he just like singled out like five of us in the back and we're like, all you guys are not allowed in my class. And then he was talking about like his last name and he was married to this woman or whatever, obviously. And he was just like, you harassed me and my wife. Like you've harassed you've harassed my wife.
Yeah.
And I didn't know what harass meant. So I thought it was like sexual assault. So I got fucking pissed off because I was like, Joey, I don't even fucking know your wife. I literally said it to him. I was like, I don't even fucking know your wife. And I was like, and fucking, it's the first day of class. So I'm like, and I was freaking out because I was so mad that he would make this game. I was like, I didn't even do anything. Like, I was like waiting to come in class. Like, normally, like, I'm looped in, like, with 10 people. Like, we said it in unison. So I was freaking out. And then my other friend, Sean, we get into class and then he starts yelling at that kid too, saying, Sean, you called me Mr. Gayworth, like something, whatever. Sean has a gay mom, right? So he's
I guess he has two.
Well, yeah. Well, like his parents, and then they split up and then.
Gotcha.
Right.
So he only cares about one of the moms.
Okay. Yeah. So he's like, I didn't fucking say anything about you being gay or Gayworth, whatever. He's like, I didn't say that. He's like, how do you know I'm not gay? He's like, I am gay. Joey's my lover. At this point, like, I'm out of it. You know, he ripped me back in.
He slurped you back in.
So then he's like, I'm going to call your parents, like, whatever. So we had this thing called a section sheet where if someone misbehaved, like the teacher would have to sign off every single class. If your class was bad, they gave you this section sheet. So they would know at the end of the day who was misbehaving. So on the section sheet, this was the first period of the day. You wrote this kid's name, Sean, whatever, and then my name. And then in quotes wrote, I'm gay, Joey's my lover. So the rest of the day, all of these teachers are reading that. Like, and I have no idea what they're thinking.
That's fucking awesome.
Yeah, I was like, what the fuck is going on? And then later he calls his mom's house. And I called him. And I like three-wayed or whatever, so we could listen to the message. And you can hear Sean in the background because he called him in the middle of class. He's like, your son was making gay remarks or saying whatever the fuck. You hear Sean in the background like, I'm not a little fucking kid. Right? I was like, oh my God, bro. His parents thought it was like funny.
That is funny.
But we were, but I remember just being like, dude, why the fuck did you bring me into this?
Bro, I wish, like, I unfortunately, like, if there were stupid things said in class, I've never called, like, a teacher gay or, like, that fucking aggressive.
Yeah, no.
But, like, if there was something being said in a class, like, that was, like, being, like, mean to the teacher, unfortunately, it probably was me that said it.
Dude, I've seen a kid punch a teacher.
I've never done that.
This kid, it was actually one of my friends. I knew
a kid that fucked a teacher.
That's cool.
That's a fuck. They fucked.
Not when
we were there.
Oh, like afterwards when he graduated?
No, no. When he was still a student, he had sex with his teacher.
That's fucking crazy.
Which, like, I get it's bad, but, like, as a kid, you're like,
yeah.
Like, you're fucking the man.
Yeah. I asked my Italian teacher to prom in high school.
She
said no.
Yeah. Well, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Years later at your grandmother's wake, I asked one of our second grade teachers to come and hang out.
Yes, you did.
Yeah, you didn't want me to tell that story, did you?
No, I didn't care.
Oh, okay. Oh, what? I said grandmother's wake and you got triggered?
No. She's dead, Joe. Let it go.
Just let it go.
No, but this kid, George, he was hiding in a...
Yo, I remember you telling stories about this kid, George.
Yo, he was crazy.
Psychopath.
He was hiding in the top shelf of this, like, thing.
Cubby.
As well as my friend Chris. He was in the bottom. And, like, the teacher comes in and, like, he's a substitute teacher. This is why it was mayhem when there was a substitute.
Bro, if you were a substitute teacher, you were lower than dirt.
Dude, especially in that school. Like, it was no, like, everyone just basically tell you to shut up.
Yo, if you went into a, like, substitute teacher means free period. If you were a substitute teacher and you were like, yo, we're actually going to learn, like, you might
good
as well.
Luck.
Yeah, dig for fucking black gold, which is oil.
Okay.
That's where I was going.
But anyway, so they were in this thing and the guy comes to the back as everyone's like laughing or whatever. He opens it up and he's like pissed off. And Chris just gets out and then George is at the top. And George is just kind of like, the fuck? I don't care. So he's like, I'm staying up here. So the teacher grabs him and like pulls him out and he kind of like falls to the ground and just gets up and socks the teacher in the
eye. Dude, what?
And then runs out of the classroom.
What?
And I was like, what is happening?
Bro, I would never... it takes a lot. I've punched, like, 3 people in the face in my whole life.
I would never in a million years...
And I don't know if I'd ever hit a fucking person of authority.
No.
Do you remember the times I've punched people in the face?
I remember... Well, there was Franny.
Ooh, Franny.
I remember when you punched David, too.
David got hit.
That was the funniest one.
Yeah, that was a good one.
David threw a handball.
Honestly, back to David.
It was a good throw.
Very good throw.
Kid threw a handball pretty decently far. Hit Frankie right in the face.
Bro, in the face. In the eye.
Hit Frankie right
like
in the eye.
A fucking, like a blue handball directly in the eye. And I was like, yo, this fucking hurts.
Yeah.
So I was just like, I can't be.
I have to do something.
I have to do something.
Yeah.
Because he was hysterical. He was like laughing and like scratching his ankles as he was standing up. He had long arms.
Yeah, he did have long arms.
And I just had to hit him. But I felt bad, but I had to, you know?
Frankie, like, walked up to him, and then he kind of, like...
That's it, man. I'm fucking, like, Jason Voorhees. I'm an evil bitch.
This is, like, it, like in the park, like, in the basketball court. They kind of, like, walked up to each other. And David's, like, apologizing, kind of. And it's just kind of like, yo, my bad, like, whatever. I wasn't even, like... I didn't think I was going to hit you. And Frankie's just, like... I could just see in his eyes. He's seeing red. And Frankie, like, says something, and then, like, doesn't do anything at first. And then, like, punches David, but he, like, kind of blocks it, but he definitely hit David in, like, the head.
Yeah.
And then as he's walking away, he just goes, think about it. And I'm sitting there on the side going, what is he talking about?
Think about what? He needed to think about what he did.
He's like, think about it.
Think about it, man. I mean,
and it was just like, what?
If you're going to walk away and you're going to leave any, you know, like, little tidbit of, like, knowledge, just, yeah. Like, think about it. It's a pretty good one.
Yeah.
You know, not a bad one to bestow upon them.
I remember David one time slapped the fuck out of somebody and then nothing happened.
Bro, like, good for you. I remember once another David story because we used to wrestle with David was like the king of wrestling.
Yeah.
This kid had every toy, every tape.
Yeah.
Everything.
All the WrestleManias like taped.
Yo, you want it? What you want to see a Shawn Michaels match?
Bang.
Like literally a tub of tapes.
Yeah.
And we would go to his house and wrestle all the time. And we would wrestle at the park.
Yeah.
Bro, the park had a fucking, like, rubber mats that were perfect for wrestling. And I remember him and I wrestled, and I went to kick him in the stomach to give him some move, but he, like, moved too quick. And I kicked him in the stomach, and he went to the corner and started calling his mom. And I just, like, took the phone and, like, hung it up and, like, put it down. I was like, you don't need to do that. You don't need to do it.
Don't say that.
Don't.
Yeah, but you know what? Just good times.
It's good times, man. Good times. Well, how did we, where did we go?
I'm going to say something right now.
Do it.
The pee is going to come out.
Is it a fat, like, do you have a fat wiener right now?
My wiener.
Do you have a sham wow?
Yeah. It's just filled to the brim with piss right now.
Sham wiener.
I may have to sit down to pee right now. Like, that's how crazy it is.
Be honest, I'd prefer to sit down to pee.
Yeah.
It's just fun.
I mean, it's not fun. I mean, whatever. I have to piss really bad. So, Frank, where can they find you?
Oh, you can find...
Comedy!
Yeah, gotcha. FAlvarez8085 on Twitter, TheFrankAlvarez on Twitch and Instagram. And then go check out the Patreon, patreon.com/TheBasementYard. Sign up. You get every weekly episode a week in advance. Sign up for that next tier. You get exclusive episodes Friday at 7 a.m. Start your week on Mondays with an episode. End your week on Friday with an episode. And they're a little spicy. So, check it out. Right now, patreon.com/TheBasementYard, and I'm a competitor in the Movie Trivia Showdown. Go check it out.
You guys can follow me at Joe Santagano. Go follow the show at The Basement Yard on TikTok and Instagram, and that is all.
I almost fell.
See you guys next
time. Go pee.